In this video, we'll cover various concepts like magnetization, magnetic intensity, hysteresis loop, and susceptibility. I'll go through each of the points, but the basic first. Let this be a coil where current is, I is the current which is flowing through the coil. This coil will produce a magnetic field. In the solenoid, we know the magnetic field inside the solenoid, inside I am saying, is mu 0 n I. This is the magnetic field inside the solenoid when there is no material. I'll write it as B0. This part, n times I, is called the magnetic intensity. Magnetic intensity. Don't get confused with magnetization and magnetic intensity. They are quite different. Magnetic intensity relates to the current which is flowing in the coil. It is dependent on the current, and we use the notation H for this. So in the problem, wherever you get the magnetic intensity, value of magnetic intensity is given. It is nothing but N times I. So B0 is mu 0 H. That is one part of it. Now suppose we place a material inside the coil. If we place a material inside the coil, the magnetic field inside the material will not be this. It will have a different expression, and let that be B is equal to B0 plus something. That something is this magnetic field inside the material will be more than B0 because of this something. What is this something? This something is a thing which is dependent on material and dependent on the current which is flowing in the coil. Means it is effectively dependent on H. This is dependent on current, means dependent on H, since H and I are related, and one, it is dependent on the material. So there is some magnetic field, I'll write it as B dash, which will appear inside the material, which will act to the magnetic field in absence of the material, and this value is mu 0 times M. This is the magnetization. Means some magnetization is happening inside the material, and it is producing, it is resulting in a magnetic field which is adding to B0. Of course, if it is ferromagnetic and paramagnetic material. So now this M, value of M, has to be written as, value of M becomes, M, I said, is proportional to material. In some books, they also use I for magnetization. You can use M or I. Some books use I, some books use M. It is dependent on material and also on H. H is the magnetic intensity. So magnetization is dependent on magnetic intensity and the material. And we write this as X. This is the susceptibility. Susceptibility of the material to magnetization. And this is H. H is the magnetic intensity, which is dependent on current, and magnetization is dependent on both magnetic intensity and the type of material, and this is the susceptibility. Susceptibility of the material. Now we come back to our main equation. The magnetic field which is emerging inside the material is B0 plus mu 0 M. B0 is equal to mu 0 H. This is mu 0 H, and mu 0 times M. M is X. X is not the right word for it. It is xi. It is susceptibility, and H. Take mu 0 common. This is mu 0. You get mu 0 and H as common. You get 1 plus xi. This 1 plus xi is called relative permeability of the material, and we write now B is equal to mu 0 mu r times H. Mu 0 mu r times H. Mu r is relative permeability. It is equal to 1 plus susceptibility. This is 1 plus susceptibility. So B is equal to mu times H, where mu is mu 0 into mu r, and mu r is the relative permeability, and this is the permeability. There is a difference between relative permeability and the permeability. So B is equal to mu h, which is, interestingly, when there was no material, B0 was mu 0 h, but when there is material, B is equal to mu h, where mu is the permeability of the material, and mu is equal to, as I said, this we can write also as mu 0 mu r times H, also as mu 0 1 plus a xi times H. So this is about the relationship between the magnetic intensity, magnetization, and the resultant magnetic field in the material when it is placed inside the coil. Now let us take the case of hysteresis loop. Hysteresis loop is a very simple way of showing how the material behaves when it is placed inside the coil in terms of the magnetic field which is appearing inside it. So if we take this as x-axis and we plot H here. H is what? Is magnetic intensity. Try to remember it by using H is equal to Ni. You can relate I to intensity so that I don't get confused. Magnetic intensity and magnetization. Magnetic intensity, I for I, H is equal to Ni. So this is magnetic intensity, and here we plot magnetization. There is a relationship, as we said, in the magnetization, and magnetic intensity has a relationship for a given material. Now when we place, we take a coil, there is a material, and we are passing current through the coil. This is the material inside the coil for which we are plotting this graph. When the current is zero, magnetization is also zero. So we start from here, and when you increase the current, magnetization increases, but relationship is not linear, and you reach a point of saturation, and this is the value of H0, or this saturation point. This is the maximum value of magnetization, and we show it by arrow. Now, when we start reducing the current, initially current was zero, it is increasing, magnetization is increasing, it reaches saturation. Now we start reducing it. We will see that the curve doesn't come back in this direction. It rather takes this shape. It comes back like this. Why it happens? Because all the magnetic movements inside, because when the current is passed, there is a magnetic movement inside which is developing inside the coil. They are aligning like this. And when you start reducing the current, the disorientation doesn't take place as a relationship with decrease in current. Like when you were increasing the current, there was initially these were in random orientation. When you increase the current, they started aligning along the direction of the magnetic field produced by the coil. But when you start reducing it, the current backwards, means current is coming down, the oriented poles do not get disoriented at the same rate. So even when the current has been brought to zero, there remains a magnetization, and this part is called retentivity. This is retentivity, means the magnetization which has been retained even when the current is zero. Now, but we want magnetization to become zero. It is not becoming zero despite the fact that current has been reduced to zero. So the only way left with us is we now reverse the direction of current. Now we reverse the direction of current. When you start reversing the current, then it starts falling down, down, and a point comes when magnetization becomes zero. And this we have done by force, because we have now made the flow of current in the opposite direction. So this is called coercivity. We have applied coercive magnetic intensity to bring the magnetization to zero. Now if you keep on giving the opposite current in this opposite direction, again the orientation starts taking place, but this time in the opposite direction. And likewise, you get, as you had the saturation point at H0, which is minus here, you get the saturation point. It will not increase, of course, in the opposite direction. This is now happening in the opposite direction. It will not increase beyond a point. This is the saturation point. Now, and this is the direction we have to show. Now, we start reducing this current which we were flowing in the opposite direction. Again, it will not get disoriented in the same manner as orientation had taken place. And even if you reduce the current to zero, this graph will actually come like this. Yes. Even if you reduce it to zero, the disorientation doesn't take place, and there is a magnetization in the opposite direction. This is the retentivity in the opposite direction, because current this time was flowing in the opposite direction. So you move back like this, and to make this magnetization zero, we will have to now again reverse the current in the original direction. You flow the current in the original direction, and then the disorientation takes place, and here you get it zero. It is coming like this, and you again increase the current in this direction itself, so it goes like this. So this is the hysteresis loop, and the area enclosed by the hysteresis loop shows the loss of energy in form of the thermal energy. You are losing energy, you are magnetizing and demagnetizing it, and there is loss of energy. So area has a significance here. More the area, you have more loss if you are using in, say, transformer, because the current is alternating, the loss will happen if you use the material which gives the larger area. So this is the hysteresis loop. I have tried to link it with the other concept of magnetization, magnetic intensity, susceptibility, relative permeability, permeability. These may appear confusing, but these are not. If you just remember that there is a magnetization, there is a magnetic intensity, and magnetic intensity is H, which is linked with current. I said to remember it, magnetic intensity I is this, H is equal to Ni, and magnetization is M is Xi times H. These two things, if you remember, you can derive the expression, which was B is equal to mu H, where mu is the permeability of the material, which is equal to mu 0 into mu R. Mu R was 1 plus Xi. So this is all about the hysteresis loop and the related aspects. Thank you.